Oasis Audio presents The Money Saving Mom's Budget by Crystal Paine, read for you by the author. Introduction. Harried, hurried, overworked, overwhelmed, cramped for time, stressed, frustrated. Do these words describe you? Do you feel like you're constantly being pulled in 100 different directions? Do you go to bed at night feeling more tired and behind than you were the night before? Do you wish you could get your finances under control and stop spending more than you make, but feel so far behind that brushing your teeth and showering every day feel like accomplishments? This book is for you. It's not a get-rich-quickly manual. I'm not going to tell you how to make millions off the stock market, nor is it a volume on bizarre money-saving tactics that require hours of time to reap a few cents in savings. I promise I won't recommend recycling toilet paper or stuffing your pillows with dryer lint. Instead, I hope to come alongside you with simple, proven advice to help you get back on your feet and in control of your finances, to start telling your money where to go, and to begin experiencing the peace that comes from financial freedom. Saving money is going to take time and hard work. If living beneath your means or saving 65% on your grocery bills were effortless, everyone would be doing it. However, I'm convinced that anyone committed to changing their financial situation can do so if they are willing to change their habits, to persevere even when it's tough, and to keep their eyes set on the end goal. The long-term benefits of short-term sacrifices and determination can be incredible. Maybe you have piles of debt and are always behind on payments. Maybe you feel stuck in a job where you're barely keeping your head above water and you have 2 children and a dog to take care of too. The good news? You're never stuck unless you choose to be. You can choose to set goals, work hard, get creative, persevere, and make wise choices. Ultimately, these wise choices can propel you to greater financial success than you ever dreamed. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. Chapter 1. If you don't know where you're going, any train will get you there. Our culture is prone to impatience. We have fast food restaurants, microwave meals, instant coffee, disposable diapers, and overnight shipping. Every day, we are bombarded with information, how to live longer, lose weight, and make more money within minutes. Everyone is looking for a quick fix, the one-step program to have it all. I wish I could tell you that there's a simple 2-minute plan you can implement and become a millionaire tomorrow. While you might see advertisements promising you ways to make $1,000 per day with little or no effort, shortcuts and gimmicks to financial freedom will ultimately fail and land you back in the same place you started, or worse. There's no way around it. True financial success is bred and born of patience, sacrifice, hard work, determination, and discipline. Until you stop messing around and start getting down to business, you'll likely live your life running around in circles, never getting a handle on your finances. As I've run MoneySavingMom.com over the last 5 years and interacted with thousands of readers in person and through email, one thing always astounds me. Only a few people know how to take the first step toward financial stability. Oh yes, many people have lots of great big ideas. They want to make $1 million or move to a bigger house or land a 6-figure salary. However, very few people know how to make their ideas reality. But guess what? You can. It starts with a very simple principle. Rule number 1. Set big goals and break them down into bite-sized pieces. You have a choice. You can stand and gaze at the mountain you want to climb and think about how it's too steep, too treacherous, and too overwhelming because you have too much debt, too many bills, or too small an income to get where you want to be. Or you can map out a way to reach the summit, put on your mountain climbing gear, and take the first step, and the next step, and the next, paying down one bill, saving up for a big purchase instead of buying on credit, or clipping coupons to catch your grocery bill. Even if you don't succeed in climbing all the way to the top, though I hope you do, if you don't know where you're going and don't take the first step, you'll never get anywhere at all. A can-do, committed attitude can propel you to greater financial success than you ever dreamed. Don't waste another moment sitting and sulking about your struggles or how you wish you had more money, more time, or a better job. Commit to change right now. The only way to gain traction and make significant progress is by setting specific, realistic written goals and then breaking those goals down into bite-sized pieces. How to begin goal setting. Number one, clear out a one-hour block of time in your schedule this week. That might not seem possible if you have a jam-packed calendar, but I promise it will be worth it. Skip your evening television ritual, get up an hour earlier, or find some other creative way to squeeze it in. Number two, sit down with a blank piece of paper or use the chart found on the PDF included with this audio and ask yourself, where do I want to be financially 5 years from now? Number three, write down everything that comes to mind, the big ideas, the little ideas, the sane ideas, and the crazy ideas. Write them all down. There are no wrong answers. Well, if you say you want to amass $50,000 in debt, that is a wrong answer. Number four, after you've brainstormed a bunch of ideas, go back through them and choose three goals. Pick one financial goal you are sure is possible in the next 6 months to a year. Pick one financial goal that you think you could reasonably achieve in the next few years if you really set your mind to it. Finally, pick one financial goal that you love but that feels like a near impossible goal. And note, if you have credit card debt or car loans, medical debt, student loans, or any other consumer debt, paying it off should be your primary goal. Once you've paid off your consumer debt, prioritize paying off your mortgage or saving for a large down payment on a home. Number five, write down your three goals. If you feel like you are spinning your wheels and getting nowhere financially, this one step will change everything about how you view your money. Writing down your goals focuses your energy and allows you to start moving forward toward a specific target. Your written goals become your financial roadmap, giving you purpose even during the most mundane day-to-day tasks like grocery shopping. They also serve as encouragement for you to press on, even if you have a month of unexpected bills and setbacks, or if you're going at a slower pace than you'd hoped. Number six, break your goals into bite-sized, measurable pieces. Figure out what you need to do over the next 5 months or 5 years, depending upon the goal, to accomplish each of your goals. Break these goals down into yearly chunks, break those yearly chunks down into monthly chunks, and then break the monthly chunks down even further into weekly chunks. If you're struggling to break a goal down into bite-sized pieces, start with when you want to accomplish the goal and work backwards. For instance, if you want to pay off $1,500 in credit card debt over the next 12 months, divide $1,500 by 12 months. This gives you a figure of $125 per month. Divide the $125 monthly goal by 4 to get your weekly goal of $32 per week. Determining the weekly amount of $32 gives feet to the goal. Now you know exactly how much extra you need to make or save each week in order to pay off that $1,500 credit card in the next year. While $1,500 might seem like a big amount, especially if you're living on a tight budget or struggling to make ends meet, once you break it down into the bite-sized piece of $32 per week, it becomes much more realistic and doable. It's not enough to just have that dollar figure, though. You also need to have a specific plan for how you'll actually come up with that extra money. Will you work a few extra hours each week? Have a big garage sale or take on an extra side job? Cut or lower some of your expenses? Think through your monthly spending and see if there's something you can reduce or eliminate for at least a year in order to accomplish this goal. I'll be sharing hundreds of ways to lower your expenses creatively in the following chapters, but for now, if you can't come up with any way to scrape together an additional $32 per week to put toward your $1,500 credit card debt, then you probably need to go back to the drawing board and extend your time frame for completing the goal to something more realistic. Maybe you need 18 months or 24. The last thing you want to do is set yourself up for failure from the get-go. Some of your financial goals might not be so concrete. For instance, if you want to increase your income by $500 per month, developing a plan of action isn't going to be as clear-cut. You'll probably need to allow for some variables, but don't let that keep you from setting the goal and breaking it down into bite.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.